Yes, no.
All right. So it's 1 o'clock, and I think we've got introduction.
Okay, good.
Knows everyone at the table. I just will let you know that Cheryl and Marie and I, like the group, we had lunch together.
Nice.
Yeah, because I thought that Cheryl should get to know the senior center and a little bit about.
And that's wonderful.
Well, you know what we do there, and Marie hadn't been to the senior center since Paula Clark had invited her. So it was really good to get her in there and see what was going on, and I just thought it was a good way to kind of introduce.
Those two are probably very popular.
Bring everybody up to speed, so we're
at
the table. Yeah. Okay, so the first thing we're going to talk about today is the conversation, and we're glad that Doak is here. Looks like you got a lot of pieces of paper there in front of you.
Yeah,
what you
got?
Okay, so I wrote a few things up last night. I don't know that you have this, Doak. Did I send this to you? I think
we can make it happen.
Did I send this to you last night?
Yeah.
Okay. So, things to consider. A method of outreach, U.S. mail, email, Facebook, website, web app review. A design, do we do a postcard, a flyer, or a more formal invitation? Which might make it look kind of fancy, you know, a small envelope, you know, a formal invitation. And what is the timeline? If we whatever we decide to do, it seems to me that it's going to take us 2 weeks from the time we decide till it gets out in the mail.
At least. Right. Because even if our part takes a week to design, wordsmith, we still have to work with the printer on the printing and the mailing.
Right.
And I don't know what that will take on their part. We have to see, like, if we work with ASAP, what their time frame would be for turning it around for us.
Right. So. And so, given that is a consideration, two is short, three is probably reasonable.
Yes.
There's no way we can do this in December.
Correct.
I mean, that's just
realistic that we can probably do it in December.
So I think that we should look at January times to do it, and if we have to be reasonable about notice.
Okay.
So if we, and we have discussed having a meeting at the senior center for our patrons and the people who are used to coming to the senior center, and doing it right after lunch, so they don't have to go anywhere, and we just continue on, and we just move from lunch to a conversation.
I think that's great.
So that one I would think we would do on Wednesday. The next one, which is Thursday, would be for community leaders and other seniors that we've reached out to the community and engaged, to invite them into the conversation. And then there would be a follow-up meeting. Am I correct, Doak? A follow-up meeting where we would share the findings. So everyone who was invited to the first meeting and the second meeting would be invited to see and hear what the results were.
It's a validation session.
Validation.
They actually present some stuff. They say yay or nay on all the things.
Correct.
How they want to change things.
And we might do a community validation session. We might take that back into the senior center and just do a smaller one with the seniors at the senior center.
So the first one, you're just including the senior centers. You're going to invite the public to that one?
Well, they could be invited, but it would be primarily targeted at the senior center. Anyone could know about it who wanted to. We couldn't come on Thursday. They could come on Wednesday.
Include it.
Right. So how did? And then I thought about that wrap-up session. To do it on a Saturday, midday, 11 o'clock, when you're not competing with work. And you're not competing with, oh my gosh, it's so lousy out tonight, I don't want to go. And we're talking about January 15th, you know, I mean, it's not like they have to rush off to a Christmas party or something. But do a morning meeting with coffee and rolls and just a wrap up. Do that on a Saturday. That way, if people are working who came to the Thursday evening discussion and they want to come into that validation session, if we did it during the day, they couldn't come, but if they did it on a Saturday, they might be more likely to. Mm-hmm. What do you feel about Saturdays?
Well, my first idea was, oh man, I get another one of my days. But then you mentioned coffee and donuts. That's what I thought. That was my impression. So.
Yeah, Nancy, what do you think?
I think it sounds good.
I think it gives a range of options.
Yeah.
It really does.
I think so too.
Right after lunch, evening, weekend, Saturday.
Yeah.
So.
Could you look at the dates? I mean, the follow-up is gonna be within just a couple of days of the second meeting. Doesn't, don't need more time than that to compile a summary.
Well, it should be made available to people before the meeting, so.
Okay.
If you let it send out, we could be just online.
Sure.
So when would the, when is it logistically feasible to do a finding session?
And you're doing the Survey Monkey. When's the cutoff date from the Survey Monkey? And when are you sending that out?
We haven't talked about that yet. We're talking about the.
So you're saying that the Survey Monkey's gonna end at the second meeting date?
We haven't talked about the Survey Monkey right now. We're just talking about the conversations.
Well, if you're talking about the follow-up meeting, though, you have to know when the Survey Monkey ends, too.
Yeah.
We do. A survey.
A little five-question survey for people who can't attend or who want to just fill out.
Give us
a quick
online.
Online.
Okay.
True. So how much time do we need between these conversations?
It would be if
I didn't hear you.
It would be nice if it was the last week of January for the validation.
So you need like 2.5 weeks.
Yep, okay.
So we could have to be enough.
So on Saturday the 28th?
That's what
I'm sitting. Yeah.
That's the last Saturday of the month?
I could probably manage the 21st if you want to.
Oh, the Saturday before that was the 21st. That's enough time a week?
I could probably do it. What is that?
You'd have to clear your schedule, is what you're saying.
He's not scheduled.
He's retired. He does fun work like that. Okay, so January 11th, January 15th, and then January 21st.
No.
January 11th, January 12th.
Well,
sorry, and then January 21st.
What time is the 12th
meeting? Well, I have 6:30 down here. I think that's open. It could be 6, it could be 5, it could be 5:30, it could be 7. It needs to be a time when people could get there after work. I'm thinking, you know, about Ryan Finwan's list. He's going to want to be at these conversations.
Probably.
When he gets off work about 5:30, and he would be able to be out here by 6.
Yeah. He comes to board meetings at 6.
Yeah, so 6:30, what do you think?
6 o'clock.
6 o'clock?
No, I think
6:30, good time to get something.
Yeah. I don't know why everybody's here.
And the impact grant for this year, they do a preliminary review. You fill out a preliminary application, and it's due the end of February. So if we get this done at the end of January, then we would have enough time for that data to use that data to move this process forward. And then
that's the people that gave us the grant to do
the kitchen
and the building remodel.
Uh-huh. So that preliminary is the end of February, and then they review those, and at the beginning of March, they tell you whether or not you can fill out a full application, which would be due at the end of April.
How elaborate is the application?
It's not very complicated. I think it's just a letter of intent. Yeah.
Yeah, the first round is easy.
Yeah. Okay, so that's good, because I want us to be able to look at some funding options once we've had a chance to get the questions answered. All right, so So as I see it, it's January 11th, January 12th, and January 21st.
Okay. One more question. The 21st at 11 o'clock?
Uh-huh.
We're going to have donuts.
Donuts and coffee, uh-huh.
Yep. Okay. We'll grab them. I just wanted to know if you were supposed to be meeting at 9 or something. Okay.
All right.
I can sleep in.
Yeah, right.
Sleep in.
Donuts and coffee. All right, so the materials, the production materials. We have an invite, which could be a postcard, which they wouldn't have to read. They would just look at it and turn it over, and there would be the information. Or a formal invitation, which would come in a little envelope, nice paper, and they open it up, and it would say Bath. You know, we have our Bath logo. And then inside would be the invitation. We could do it on Bath note card stationery. We have that note card stationery. So what do you think is better? And who are we mailing this to? In my opinion, the mailing would go to, we have an outreach list here. It happens to be part of it on the back. But I think that we would mail invitations to the churches. Here you go. Mail invitations to the churches, to the Legion, to the Auxiliary, the Lions.
Red
Hatters. Yes, I think they were
on there. Yeah, Red Hatters. I didn't read that off because I know that Alice and a lot of them go to the Senior Center. We could just hand them their invitations, you know, at the Senior Center. We could just hand out invitations at the Senior Center. The Museum Committee. So, I just wonder how many invitations we would actually need to mail. In the U.S. Post Office.
Okay. I personally like the one postcard thing so you can read it quick, get it in the mail, read it, save it if you want, don't save it if you don't.
But do you... I'm just going to tell you what I do, especially during like campaign season. Oh, I can a lot of that stuff.
Oh, yeah.
I get in the mail. So I don't want people to think it's junk, political or junk mail and just can it. I mean, maybe if it just screams Bath Township and senior, you know, maybe it's the look and the feel of it that gets people to not just
yeah, it's not election time, so then yes. I would be having more attendance. But that's just my opinion.
Yeah.
I'm just like Karen. I look at it, and if it's political, I throw it out.
Yeah.
But if it said, you know, it had Bath Township seal on the front of it, you know, and then Bath Township Senior Center, and then you turned it over, and we're inviting you to a conversation about the Senior Center, I think it's really a lot easier for people to read.
Yeah.
But then if you put Senior Center on the front, the younger crowd isn't going to, they're going to pop it. Senior Center, oh, I'm not a senior.
So it doesn't have to say Senior Center, I'm going to just say Bath Township. But. So
do you have thoughts, or have you had success?
No, I didn't have
it. In a certain methodology.
I just don't want to look at one of those things. You're invited to a free meeting for a state dinner for hearing.
Oh,
so
Yeah.
I'll show those later.
Do you, are those in envelopes or are they cards?
Cards, usually.
Okay,
well, both, actually. But, I don't know, an important community meeting or something like that. I mean, is that the kind of phrase that would get people to pay attention?
An important community meeting, yeah.
I think somebody doesn't look like other stuff, but holds up a wide range of people.
I think we all
work
at dinner.
I think we all work at steak dinner.
Well,
I would have expected that comment from Dean.
Have you ever
done it? She's the food one today.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So, what do you think? What the invitation?
A postcard or an invitation or a flyer?
What the library put together was, what does the future of Bath Township Public Library look like? And I think that's a pretty
good one. Oh, thank you.
I think keep that kind of catchy.
My first thought was a postcard, so.
Okay. And a postcard can make into a flyer. You can make a postcard into a flyer. You can put them up around town and.
The library just did something very similar to what we're trying to do.
So they had this strategic planning meeting at the library at 7:00, people came.
Seven?
Seven. And then the second time, they had two nights, and the second time, 8 people came. And five of them were the best township.
That was for that.
For the library, yeah, recently. So it's that personal invitation that gets people to the table. So no matter how we mail them, email them, poster them, flyer them, it's those phone calls that we make to the homeowners association over where Karen lives and the homeowners association down there in the Pines. And it's those personal conversations and those one-on-one contacts that's really going to make a difference that people come. But if we did flyers, we could even put them in the churches. They could slip them in their bulletin boards, you know what I mean? Or they could hang them on their bulletin boards.
Yeah.
So I think flyers are really important, and I think that as a vehicle to make that into a postcard, people would begin to see it. They'll recognize that, oh, I was going to go to that conversation. You know, so I...
Well, I think the flaw here is strategic planning public forums.
Yeah, it's
just
I mean, this was, I don't mean to be, that's not rude. I've been trying to be rude.
No.
But, this is the camera. This is my life, you know? This is my life, so this is stuff that's exciting to me. But I want it to grab people's attention that don't think it's, but those words right there to people are boring.
Exactly. That's very negative.
And negative.
That means it's very boring.
So I just want to make it.
So what should ours say? What is catchy? What can we say?
I think things like, you know, like I said, simple things like an important community meeting or
taking care of our senior citizens. Care for growth.
Taking care of our senior citizens.
That's what even if it's in care. If it's a young person, you got a parent, you got an aunt, an uncle.
Pardon me? That sounds super positive.
She said caring for our seniors.
Girls of the time like that.
Is that what you said?
Yeah, because you're three persons, young kids, you still have parents.
Yes.
Planning growth of the seniors around us.
Because even if
they want to help with that.
That's true.
You know, what probably what you say in the conversation.
What were the three words that we came up with you when Judy and you and I met? It was like the three words that we thought embodied
helping our seniors
in that. Oh, those are the birds. That was the vibrant, fulfilling, beautiful.
I was trying to think if those would play into this.
I changed. You see this piece that I gave to the township board. What should we do to make Beth Senior Center a more vibrant, fulfilling, and welcoming place for seniors?
Shorter words. Support for us.
We would love for you to attend the community conversation, create answers to questions together with other township residents. In order to accommodate everyone's schedule, the conversation will be held at two different times. You only need to attend one, whichever is most convenient for you.
Yeah, but for that headline phrase, I don't think those are necessary.
No, I was just trying to remember what they were.
Yeah.
What should we do to make Bass Senior Center a more vibrant, fulfilling, and welcoming place for seniors?
You find it happen in body somewhere.
Yeah. The headlines. Care for our seniors. Something short, sweet, and
care for our seniors. Caring for our seniors.
Although that sounds more like healthcare.
Yes. Caring about our seniors.
Taking care
of our seniors.
Or caring
about our seniors.
What do you think?
Seniors, here we go. So who will
handle taking care of sounds like
support.
Okay. Well, I have supporting. Caring about our seniors.
Supporting our seniors. Yeah, I think supporting our seniors. Because that's what it's about. Food, it's not medical care, it's supportive in all different ways.
Caring.
Cards, supporting.
You like supporting better than caring?
Mm-hmm.
Seniors, supporting our seniors. Because they can interpret caring two ways.
Yeah.
Caring for them and caring about them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, so who will handle the production of this?
We can work with, Taylor already works with ASAP, so I think that's probably the best route. She doesn't have to design it. They have designers on staff too, so.
Does that cost us money?
Yes.
To use the designer out there?
It's probably worth it.
But honestly, this is gonna come from the money that's been allocated.
Yeah, but it does get over it.
I'm not saying that we have unlimited time.
Yeah, we don't have to worry about it.
We don't have to worry about it.
I should have a meeting after, so I kind of just left it short. What the library said that they invited, I don't know which, they had invited over 30 people and they did 3 meetings and there was only like 7 people at each meeting and they didn't get any diversity.
Was that Christy?
Background.
Yeah.
And they were all very disappointed about it. Because they sent out an invitation to everyone in the township.
I didn't get one.
And.
Well, I don't remember getting one.
I don't.
And they did the monkey. They did the monkey. In October, end of October. And she said they just couldn't draw anybody. And like, you know, Dana knows the church and you know the answer to that phone, that called Ogama Village, got the answer machine with that, and I was calling back on that. And then the little bit of interaction with the police and the fire department got not really. So I ran into not very much.
Well, and actually,
what
I said was we needed a date and a focus before we really do a lot of outreach. Mm-hmm. You know, and there are certain people within the fire department that perhaps should be targeted for an invitation. Like, we have a fire safety guy now.
Mm-hmm.
And that's his job, is fire safety. Mm-hmm. If we're talking about issues related to the senior center and whether or not we can bring more people in there and we can, you know, change the tables to long tables instead of round tables and sit more people in there. He's the one who's really got to answer those questions. So the fire guy, you know, fire code guy is the guy we really want to specifically invite. So we need a Facebook presence. This has to be on the website. And we can put back something in the Do It Beth review about it.
Now, wait a minute. Karen, go ahead. Taylor will do the website?
Yes. So Taylor and Jenna do Facebook.
Okay.
So that they do the senior center Facebook specific page. Okay. And we have the general township page.
Okay.
And then I'll tell them time to try to push those things out to the community page.
Okay.
The core pages.
Okay. Where else were you going? Back to what review? Who will do that?
We submit things to them all the time.
Okay.
Yeah.
So Jenna and.
But it would depend on if we were trying to get the free ad or if we were trying to actually place an ad for people to come.
It could be in the senior center. I mean, it could be under the senior center activities as well.
Yep.
Yeah, and we could put an ad. We could put our flyer in there.
Just a brief.
Just a little
like this.
Yeah.
Well, I've been getting a few different invitations through email. It just seems like everything they have is colorful and eye-catching and.
Who's on those?
I just cut and paste. You know where it brings you down to.
We have a subscription to a thing called Canva, and it helps you create.
Yeah, that'd be perfect because then it's like you can click on links to find out more information, click on links to confirm you're going to attend. You know, click on links for details, but. It just seems like everything that comes through is just kind of festive and fun at the very top to draw you in.
So we said that if we're going to do it on the 11th, the deadline for going, you know, reaching out is the 28th of December.
Yes.
So, I mean, we haven't even started the month of December yet, so that gives them us 30 days. Right? So if we shoot for that target of the 11th and the 12th, let's go back to the monkey survey, right? Because we should have the results by the end of that last session.
Can we push it another week or not? Can we go? Because I'm thinking 11th, that's just, you know, 2 weeks after Christmas. January. You know, barely taking the Christmas tree down and you're expecting people to show up for the gathering in the community. I'd like to see it pushed back another week, I think.
Yes, so what are we doing with the date, the survey?
You mean the 18th, the 19th, and the 28th?
Yeah, I think that's a better... I think that's a better date.
Oh, 18. Oh, okay. So 18, 11, 12, 21.
I'm saying go 18, into 19. The 18th and 19th and then the 28th instead.
Instead of what?
Instead
11, 12,
of
11, 21. 12,
and the 21st.
Okay. Okay, so bring those up.
I'm just saying, you know, Christmas is overwhelming and you still got your tree up and you're expected to go to a community meeting. I don't think people are in the mode for that yet. They're just returning the gifts they didn't like. They're just cleaning up from guests leaving. It's just been the new year a week ago. I think that you'd have a better show if you bump it back a week, if it's possible to meet your deadline for the grant application and such.
So push it down farther.
18, 19, 28.
So the 18th would become the 25th, 19th, the 26th.
No, 18, 25, 11, 19, and 22 for the validation. So those are due March 1st. So that would be good. Yeah, if it's a letter, preliminary report, you'll get enough. So we're going to do 18, 19, and 28.
She gave us two choices, and I'm saying
Okay.
You're going to hit.
So 18, 19, and 28.
Okay. Meeting for the 6th.
The township
board meeting on the 6th.
Uh-huh.
If we're reporting back.
Right. Well, we have to.
Yes.
They should be at the meetings. They don't need the report back, but we'll go and talk to them. Chair will be our spokesperson out there. Okay. 18, 19, and 28. How does that work for you, Dick?
We're just talking about.
You see your name, like, you're like her favorite buddy that she keeps messing up on.
I know. He's smiling. That's all that matters. We're talking about the board of trustees and taking that that's the board that runs this township. February 6th.
Oh.
So it will be after the validation meeting. So it gives us time. I'm sorry, I didn't understand what you were asking. It gives us time to prepare for them.
So you're doing, are you talking about 11 o'clock on Saturday?
Yes, 11 a.m.
Don't you have to offer lunch or something if you're going to keep...
We're having donuts and coffee. That's why I thought maybe we should be earlier.
Either 10 o'clock or 1 o'clock. Yeah, if you're doing donuts and coffee, can you do it 10 o'clock? That's reasonable. 11 o'clock is getting too close to lunchtime.
I don't know, I'm up at 4 a.m.
Two,
I am all the time. That's my day. It's when I wake up.
I think 10
I'm just teasing.
10 o'clock?
10?
Yeah, that way they know they're going to be home for lunch and then it's not going to be.
And early. A lot of people do. I'm making a joke because I just, as I get older, I wake up earlier. So I figure that they're up and they're ready to go. So I think that 10 o'clock would be fair. Oh. Really?
Oh yeah.
So
experience is not universal.
So now we've made another change.
It might be
10 o'clock on the 21st. And
okay. 28th.
I'm sorry, on the 28th is 10 o'clock.
I'm gonna have to rewrite this.
Yep.
You're not gonna be able to read my own brain. Okay, let me ask
No, I'm saying is it logical or not? I don't want a group of people at a meeting that's got their stomachs growling and they're like, I just want to get out of here. I want them to be comfortable and willing to open up, right?
Yep. I work as good at 9 o'clock for donuts and coffee.
Not me.
No, 10 is fine.
So we don't miss this.
Okay, so we have Wednesday the 18th at 1 o'clock at the Senior Center, Thursday the 19th at 6:30 at the Senior Center, and Saturday the 28th at 10 o'clock at the Senior Center.
Okay.
And the deadline for the invitations to be done, processed and available for us to pass out And us, it's the 4th of January.
Still gonna be the 4th.
That's the deadline, if that's the date we're gonna use. It could be done any time before that. So, monkey survey. We have questions for a monkey survey. They are in this packet down here. Additionally, a short 5-question survey. Do you have the packet? This one that has the outreach pin at the top, and then the additional, halfway down, it says additionally, a short, this what looks like in this packet. Did I go to the test? Doug has a whole section, Do you have that word packet?
That's my,
no.
I brought.
Oh,
I brought.
You just gave a bunch of papers.
Nope.
I didn't get a bunch of papers.
Are all three of these meetings at the EFC Center?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so the last time we met, these are the questions we talked about. I just want to make sure that there are the questions that I want us all to have input into this. Do you have them there in front of you, Sherry?
Let me just say that these are in a specific sequence.
Do you want to run us through these?
And the whole idea of the dialogue and the, is to the people process questions wisely. They can start with sensory stuff, then feeling stuff, then good decision stuff or insights, and then decisions. So you've got, first of all, just who comes to mind when you think of CDH? Who are the people we're talking about? How do you feel about current stresses and opportunities? And another way to say that is what excites you or pleases you or bothers you about them. Then you talk about an example of something that another person might need, but it's hard for them to get right now. See, these are going farther than just the basic questions of what do you want.
So they're all open ended.
Yeah.
So they can.
Yeah, there's plenty of space to just write whatever.
Paragraph. Okay.
And as the advisory board plans on expanding services, what is the part of that? It's about the work. Again, these events get happy. As opposed to just as a random question being thrown at me, but come up with an answer later. And then the final one is just an attempt to. Basically what you want, but it's what specific improvements would make you say, wow. And these are all in a survey right now that's available to you. The link's already there.
Oh, okay. You have
it. Is. You could even go in.
Okay, because I was going to say, we have a survey bookie.
Oh, do you? Hey, you can do it if you want.
Okay.
Whatever.
We already have it.
No, so I just put it in there so I have
sure.
To use it. Let people.
Okay. So we can give you access to that too, so you can help. Well, you can have the data. And
So these are the 5 questions for the monkey survey that we talked about the last time we met, but many of you weren't at the meeting. So I just wanted to put them out on the table again and make sure that these are the questions we want on the survey monkey. When you think of seniors living in Bath Township, what comes to mind? Who do you see? Think about how you would answer that question.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's
I think about a lot of my neighbors. I think it evokes a who are you imagining?
Mm-hmm.
We have a neighbor we help. She's physically restricted. Yeah, who comes to mind?
Your own relatives.
Yeah. Mine are gone, so.
So how do you feel about that question?
I thought it was Ghostbusters, mom. You know, it makes me think of people.
Mm-hmm. So mostly I think about older people who I know who are, mm-hmm. you know, living on the edge right now and, you know, need the programs and services. That's who I think of when I think about that question.
When you think of seniors, when you think of senior services in that township, what comes to mind?
In terms of set the landscape right now?
The second question is about the services.
Okay, so you're getting them, say, okay, I'm thinking about my mom, my aunt, my neighbor down here, okay, alright.
You wanna see them before you think about them.
Okay.
And then how do you feel about the current services and opportunities available to seniors in that? What's interesting is that it would be interesting to know what they know about services and opportunities.
Some might say, what services? They might not know.
Right.
Again, the purpose of this, since you get the order that we have, this is based on, I mean, the best example, this is the alarm, so you get the warning. The alarm goes off, you hear it, and you see it.
Yep.
Sensory.
Yep.
You have a feeling about it, is the next thing that happens. So the next question is about feeling, how to feel. Then you have, you go through, like, what would happen if I did this news button, what would happen if I go in safe? And all these questions, that's the next level of questions, and then what are you gonna do, what's your decision? So these are meant to recreate that experience in your mind for this question.
I wouldn't have associated all of that with how these are asked.
You're not supposed to think about it.
That's why you do what you do, Joe.
Okay, so, what's an example of something that an older resident in Bath might need or want that is hard for them to get right now?
Three and four are both living together.
Right.
This is getting where you might wanna throw the stuff you've been saying so far. Like, what do you wanna get out of them? On these two questions. Now that they have people in mind and they have their feelings taken care of, what do they want?
So I think those questions are all right.
With number four, can we do for improving / expanding? Because if we're going to improve, expand.
I wanted to ask that question. I thought something you wrote said just expansion. So are we going with expansion, or is it both improvement?
Well, if they, you know, if they end up just asking for services up here, we can improve.
Right.
But if we go ahead and want to get the expansion, then we're going to do.
That's a good point.
We're going to do.
So you think it would be square with a slash in there instead of more?
I would, because now, so my personal opinion, I would, yes, for me.
That would give them the idea to do it from two different angles instead of just four.
Yeah.
Because it can be a certain physical space.
So the deadline on the response for these would be the 19th of January, if we're going with that second set of options. At the meeting, so it would be that we would want the responses by the 15th of January. The meeting is the 18th. No, we want them by the 12th of January. 10th of January.
Yeah, there's no reason why this can't be earlier, I think. Can give me time to put it together so I can present something really quickly that can get the information that I need.
So by January 10th, that should be all right?
Yeah.
All right, good. Monkey survey.
This isn't just information that helps in front of the report. It's like it triggers the people's thoughts at the meeting.
At the meeting. So this is, okay.
So this is to be done before our community event?
Yes. I was thinking maybe you didn't understand.
This could start.
Right now?
Now.
Yeah. Do the same thing.
This part.
Yep.
For sure. Who's getting this survey?
How's it going to be delivered?
You'll put in your invitation, or you have any to put that link. I have this boilerplate language for the invitation as the way back when from our last meeting.
So,
if we change it to yours, we'll do it.
If this goes soon, like within the next week or so, we could also, there's Friday report. There's lots of things. Facebook, still website.
Right.
Senior center tables, announcements, or just anything we can do.
Right, to get the survey out.
Yeah.
And I think when we do that, we need to say this will be followed up by with a community conversation. Come to the conversation. These are the dates.
But also, go ahead.
I think if you put something on the table, they get overlooked a lot.
They do.
Yes.
Okay.
I think it needs to be announced, passed out or something.
Well, I was gonna say.
It's either or though, it's a both end, because you, I mean, you can do all these things. All this is a link.
True.
Just put the link wherever you, anytime you talk about this, put the link.
But a lot of times when we do surveys, and I'm just letting you know, we have actually handed out copies that they can write in, and staff will enter them in.
Oh.
Because some of our older adults just won't even go electronic. Some of them love it, and some of them won't even.
Oh, of course, yeah.
So, in the past, when we've done things, we've offered, if you fill it out, we'll enter it in for you.
Let me ask you while we're on that, Karen. Is there a value to using my account, because then it doesn't have to talk, I don't have to bother your staff to get at this stuff, or?
We can just add you to, as a user, as an administrator, to this.
Okay.
I think you can do it by specific survey, I think you,
the
version we have will allow us to add you as an administrator.
Okay.
Because I think our staff would be the ones entering in the written responses we receive too.
Whatever was best.
Okay.
So does the township have access to people's email accounts, the property taxes?
No, that's not, no, that's not how property taxes, everything we do goes in the mail.
Oh.
So, no, the only email addresses we have are at the police department, they have their neighborhood watch list, and then here at the township, we have like the Friday report list.
Oh, okay, that's a good one.
It is, we don't have a lot of email addresses left.
At the senior center, do they not have email addresses there for contacts as well?
Some of them do, but not all of them do.
Better reaching them with a paper invitation than.
Probably so.
Yeah, and or paper survey.
Right, email, you don't look at your email, it doesn't text you.
Do you want a free cookie turned into survey?
You want it? I love it. Thank you.
Look at this, there's my email. 2,211.
I have about 200 of my mine.
Well, darn you.
All three of those dates are.
No, I already know.
And it was in the evening, on the 18th, but we'll be done. So all three of those dates are.
And this is a Thursday.
Yep.
And so sometimes the Lions meet then, but I'm meeting with them tonight and I'll tell them, they're coming. Mm-hmm. I'll tell them that if they want a meeting that day, it could be at this event.
Okay. So all of those are available.
Yep. And I reached out to Candy at Kessler to get the Homeowner Association presidents in all the areas where they have.
The Homeowners Associations.
Where they have built neighborhoods. I've got all of their Homeowner Association leaders.
Good.
From Candy.
That's perfect.
Email them.
Okay.
And I got them from the lady, a woman who lives in the Pines, too. I'm still trying to find the Meadows.
Okay.
What's interesting is that Dan, the planning guy, Kramer lives in the Pines.
Okay.
So I might have to go to him if I haven't been successful any other way. But all right. So how are we doing here? So the monkey survey can go out anytime. I do want to know how we can be successful at talking about expansion without being able to look at the building and the particulars about the building, which an architect definitely needs to help us with, whether it's a site plan, how many parking places, can we make space for more parking places. And I really think that the township trustees did not understand that this conversation, what this conversation is or is about. I don't think they understood that in order for us to talk about expanding the programs and the services, we might have to look at expanding the building, and it's whether or not we can expand the building is critical to answering the question. So we have to have an architect. So we have to
vote.
Yes, but that's not how you voted at the board meeting.
I didn't.
And so
first meeting.
I know it was your first meeting.
I forgive you.
So we have to get back on track. So I'm wondering if at the next meeting we can talk about this again, getting an architect at the meeting.
Okay. And there is no there's no site plan of the township campus.
Okay.
There are photographs but now it's like, it's been cobbled over the years. I mean, that building used to be the fire station.
The campus.
Yeah, so there's no real, we're having surveys done in the coming year, but at this time, there's no official site plan.
Shoot, can I say something about what you bought from the architect?
Well, you were in the building, right?
Yeah, I just wanted to add something to it.
No, okay, go ahead.
We want them to give us, not want to, you know, give us what can be done or what the opportunities and the challenges would be, but be able to succinctly summarize that to people at the meeting so that we can have an hour-long presentation of that. I have about 15 minutes right now for the presentation from them for both presenting the survey stuff and whatever experts will be there to share the information. So I just want to make sure they have the capacity to, if you get an architect.
I understand what you're saying, that they need to summarize what they have learned in the process and be a good communicator so that we have the opportunity to realistically talk about expansion. And he has versed us in the possibility.
I already know one of the challenges for me is once they start talking, there'll be 100 questions that people want to ask, and that'll want to be a full meeting. Early on, so they can see it ahead of time, would be good.
Right now, we don't even have an architect. We have no permission to bring that to the table.
Okay,
so what have you got there for us to look at, Doug?
If we want to look at the process,
you would know I've known that man for 40 years.
Would you just call me?
Doug, who is Doug?
Every time it's different, I love it.
I just have a description of the meeting itself, if anybody wants it. So the first page is a short agenda. And I don't have 5 of these, so maybe somebody could take it.
I'll share with Nancy.
They can share.
I'm not sure it is right now. This is the basic agenda.
Awesome. Thanks for doing that.
And then the second 2 pages describe what happens in each one of those pieces of the agenda. You won't understand everything. And I did describe it in the proposal a little bit, but if I were to present it visually, you would see more. Again, it's all based on the sequence of inquiry thing where you go from this to this to this to this. And it's also designed to make sure every individual has input into a group that has input into the whole group, so that you have a channel that way for everybody has to say, getting on the board. And there's a big visual board that all the ideas get moved around on in the first of the use of it. But I'll just do this, and if you have questions, if you got an email, if you want to do this, if you want.
Question number 4.
I think he reached that. Services
and or expansion.
Yeah, I changed that.
Did you put both and or?
Oh, I didn't put and or, I did with slash.
Do you guys want and or just a slash?
That was good.
You want and or expansion? We're going to do,
and what do you have after or?
I'm okay with that.
Okay.
I guess you know.
This is the description. So this goes with. This is what I did.
We'll have you on the next one.
So that goes with that.
Yeah. And do you have one of those whole packets?
Do you have one more?
Yeah, I've got the 5 that I have. So there's 2 people who don't know.
I can make. Should I make 1 or 2?
2.
Okay.
Sherry, this is Dennis Lardy. Dennis Lardy is on our committee as well. Sherry is our EOP representative. Alan's place, he's gone to police and fire. And Sherry's come, Cheryl, she's come to our board, Senior Services Advisory Board. And so we had her to lunch today. We're getting her both feet wet on this right now. She's
so.
And this is Doug, Dave, Dylan.
Don't
Dennis, and Dennis is on our senior services advisory board, and he's here for the second half of the meeting, but he came a little early. All right, so what Doug has handed out, and Karen is actually making copies of, is the agenda and Doug.
The agenda, and then the second two pages, the second and third pages are the most detailed description of what each happened in each slide.
2 hours and 30 minutes, that's not a good thing to know, is it?
That was really nice for you to say that.
Okay, who's you and Dennis, and do you have one?
And then I have next one.
Okay, do you want to walk us through this, Doug?
Basically, the intro is, there's an intro question, something like, what is one thing about that makes Bath Township a great place for seniors to live? Basically, at their table, I'm assuming tables. Right now, if it's larger tables, you can just divide them up into groups among those tables. So, say a group of 5 or 6 people would quickly introduce themselves to each other and then give their answers to this question to each other. What makes that township a great place to live? And then I would take, this is all 15 minutes altogether. Once they had a chance to do that, I would try to gather answers from a number of them, having them not repeat each other. Just to fill up the time that I have, 15 minutes. It's just a way to get started, gets people used to talking on the air. Then I have 5 minutes of me presenting the process. So it will be some visuals that will describe the process they're going to go through. They won't understand it at that point, and that's fine. It's just something that they can look back to as they start to see it unfold. They might remember, oh yeah, that's what this is. This and that. And then that will cover what's going to happen. The informational presentations I have, the two basic things in it would be a summary of any survey or interview responses you have, and I would do that myself probably. Be very efficient. They should have had it ahead of time, and it's available to them online or however, so they have a chance to look at it if they want to. And then something from experts, it could be township personnel or professional advisors, I put the parentheses at the end there. This could be the architect if you get one. Highlights of limitations and opportunities for the senior citizen intervention from the perspective of those folks. I'll stop there and see if any comments or anything else. It's a short amount of time for that presentation, but it's important to get to the dialogue. I mean, what do people think, what they feel is what we want to hear, not. We don't want to have to be driven by the experts, we want to be driven by the people who are in the community. So we just want to give them a chance to speak and share highlights that are on this. Okay, moving on to number 4. This is the open dialogue, and this is the time when anybody gets to say whatever they want. I have these, they're kind of like black cardboard boards, and there'll be 3 of them on stands, easels, right? So I mean, they'll extend from like about here to maybe this far down. Ideally, I'll have some anchor cards up there that are sort of 3 things that thoughts might be broken down into. It could go any number of ways. And this is really important what they are, is that there is an idea of there are certain things we're going to think about. Mm-hmm. It could be personal, community, family, or something like that. It could be anything. But as people, I just want the question to people is, what are your thoughts about this? Well, this is a question of answer. What are you thinking about right now? The purpose of it is to get people a chance to exhaust that initial desire they have to say whatever they have to say. Right? I'm coming to this meeting, I'm going to say this. This is the chance for them to get that out of the table early enough so that we can get to the dialogue later.
High quality, affordable housing.
There you go.
And I'll
write a card for every comment that gets made, and I'll stick them on the board. Cards will just stick to it, basically. do magic, mental magic. And I moved the cards around as necessary. I put them in threads during this part recently. So basically, so if somebody says something about that, and somebody says something about that, I can go back to that that relates to that thing. And you have like a string of thoughts that, that many people contribute to. I also have color coding in my head. So it's a basic fact. It's blue. If it's a positive thing, it's green. If it's a negative thing, it's red. If it's a conclusion, it's purple. So that helps me in writing the report. I get into paragraph form all these things that they've said in this open dialogue. So we do that for 25 minutes, which is usually about the amount of time it takes to get people to say what they have to get out. And then we're ready to get formal in our process. If there's a break, then probably should be able to happen in that space too. I haven't put a break on any of them. So now we get to these summary questions. This is where I don't write anything down. Probably if you have a scribe from your office, they may be writing the answers down to this, but I think it's happening visual and public in front of the audience. I ask these questions that move them from sensory to feelings and experiences to insights and lessons to decision. And there's just about seven of them, so two for each category. I just ask the question and I ask people to give me a short answer. I repeat the answer as they say it. So I'm just going to go another one. Just doing this, it's just a matter of hearing what's in people's head as a group. The whole idea is that we act as one brain here to contribute to one flow of thought toward deciding what we're going to do when the alarm clock goes off. Okay, so once we got through those first three kind of phases of questions, then we're at the focus question, which I should have mentioned right at the beginning, and that's that
number six
thing we've already talked about. What should we do to make that touch the senior center a more vibrant, fulfilling, and welcoming place for senior center? That's the focus question of the whole meeting. All the answers that we have come up with are be based on that. So, to answer that question, that's the meat of the whole process. We're at number six now.
Six, yeah.
I asked the group at their table individually, just a little scrap piece of paper, to write down a few answers to that question, as specific, as clear as they can be. Then in their group, they quickly share what they have written down. And then they decide as a table, two or three or four, that they want to write down on these index cards. They write them down for me, using the pen that I've given them, so I know by the color which group it is. They send, when they're done with that, they give it to me. Then I go up to the board, I have all these cards, I start putting them on the board, reading them out one at a time, and as I do it, I ask them to identify similar ideas that can go together, pairs of ideas. Only pairs for a certain amount of time. It's just to make sure that we have distinct ideas. And at some point I say, okay, we're there, now we can have groups. We can have more than two in a group. This is making sense. So people are kind of following me because I can
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yes.
Okay. So what you end up with is all these little clusters of cards on the thing. Once you get through all the cards, the next thing is to label each cluster. Simple label, one word, two words, different colored paper, larger paper. Do that. Put them all named. Then this really important question, it's hard to understand at first, is which of these clusters are catalytic? It's not the same question as what's most important. What a catalytic question is it means if you do that thing, all the rest of the things and most of the rest of the things will come with it. So it's a triggering thing. If we did this one, the rest will come along. And then people nominate. People say, I think this one is, I think this one is. You pretend that there's only one, when actually it's whatever. However many people say, I put a star on them, those become the catalytic ones. And then the rest of the meeting is just sort of teasing out why is this catalytic, why is this important. Anytime I have one at the end, I go through the clusters and say, can you just tell me more about this? You know, what's your thinking behind this particular cluster? Is there more I need to know? Then I go home with all these cards in the living room and I lay them all out and I get paragraphs to capture what they said. Each cluster becomes a recommendation. This is what the group is saying. And then there's paragraphs that explain all the cards, all the cards, someplace in a paragraph. It's not like verbatim, it's like a massage it, make it sound like a good paragraph. So you have a report on each session based on that. That's what I'll be doing in that time between the two first meetings and validation session. They'll get those reports available to them, hopefully a few days before that final validation meeting. At the validation meeting, which is not covered here, basically I present each of the recommendations in really simple form, and everybody gets three cards. One's red, one's yellow, it's green, one's yellow, it's green. And after I explain what the recommendation says, hopefully they've read it already, but I explain it, so hold up a green card if you're fine with it as it is, a red card if they get a bad recommendation, if you don't want to have it, a yellow card if there's something you want to change. So then I get all those down and I just process each one. And if we come to an agreement as a group, we'll be just bouncing around, saying, okay, I think I get it, so I can take it home, put whatever it is down, rewrite the recommendation. And then you get a new report that has that.
That's good. Any questions? Great.
And I have visuals.
So, the question is the most critical piece.
Yes.
This one right here.
Yep.
What should we do to make that Township Senior Center more vibrant, fulfilling, and welcoming for seniors to attend?
The focus question always begins with either what should we do or what are some ways we can. Make sure that we're doing some strategies for actions.
You're welcome.
Going once. Any input on this?
I think it's great.
Okay, where's the question?
It's right here, number two, the overview. What should we do?
You have this sheet of paper? It's in the middle.
Probably do.
There's the middle says the goal.
Thank you. Anything else we need to talk about the conversation for right now?
Well, did you get answers to the questions?
I think I got a nod around the table that I thought it was all right.
Just time to change your promise and
So just to quickly summarize, our conversation then will be on Wednesday, December 18th at 1 o'clock.
January.
I'm sorry? Yep. Wednesday, December, January 18th at 1 o'clock.
Keep that slowly, please.
Thursday, January 19th at 6:30, and Saturday, January 28th at 10 o'clock, all at the Senior Center. We will have several ways to notify people, postcard, flyers, Facebook posts, website, news articles. The township is handling the publicity. The deadline for the publicity is January 4th. We're going to do that monkey survey, and those can go out as soon as we figure out how to do the outreach on those, maybe just through the Friday report to start with, and the Facebook page. All right.
So we're going to have a flyer and or postcard. So we could probably, I was thinking Judy and Doak would support us and look at it, review it, approve it. Maybe I'm off on that.
No, that's right.
Okay.
Yep.
So Taylor's going to do it. Taylor, and we'll work with ASAP printing.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay.
I just want to make sure. A little bit of in-house, a little bit of out.
Okay. Anything else that we need to talk about that you could see for now, Doak?
You have this.
She's called there, I think. Yeah.
You have the spoiler page. I think I sent it out after that last meeting with Taylor, right?
Okay.
There's nothing sacred about that, but okay. The idea is to be in the invitation.
I probably did get it in an email. Thank you.
Actually, you do have it.
Okay.
That's fine.
I modified it after
Dana. Yeah, we went over to, we had a meal together, meeting at the Senior Center.
Yeah. Wonderful.
All right. So, thank you, sir. Yes, we're going to move to our entertainers, Dolly Parton and Kenny Rogers, if you want to stay.
They're coming.
Yes, they are.
They are.
April 26th.
Night.
Night.
Same day as Pumpkin Jumping.
spring.
Oh, camp day is?
April 29th.
Thank you. Pleasure to work with all of you.
Thank you.
I'm on the list.
Thanks for your interest.
And March.
D-O-A.
Hey.
I wrote it in full letters.
Thank you, Garrett.
She can make this a thing.
You are an actor. I mean, you could see all these characters, yes.
If you want me to come up with a new character.
All right, so we're going to move into the entertainment part of the event. You're not, you may be this month.
But you might have a bid.
You might be able to help us.
Yeah.
You might.
Well, Kim will tell you.
Hey.
Okay, I'll stay.
Stay with us.
All right, so Kim has a list of questions that we've prepared for Karen.
This was helpful, thank you.
Kim, I'm gonna turn this over to you here.
I'm sure we'll see you better. Love the red scarf.
Bye, thanks.
Bye-bye.
Don't.
Don't worry, yeah.
Don't.
The door.
Okay, so here, Kim, you're up.
Kim, I can get you cookies. Mary is happy to make cookies.
Okay.
She is happy to, how many did you tell me tickets?
Over 400, please, hello.
Okay, so would you like your cookies in packages of one, or would you like packages of two?
We're selling them for 50 cents a piece.
Okay.
So I think they need to be individually.
So you would like 400 cookies in a bag, like packaged individually, because Mary and her staff will do that. She will do an assortment. You can tell me, or we can just let her decide. The only thing that I think in my brain is, I love peanut butter cookies, but I know people have peanut allergies.
Yeah.
So should we avoid nuts, which is probably the only thing I would think. Even though I love peanut butter, it's a food group for me. Well, some people have even if it's in the air, it can get people.
I don't think we have a problem.
Last night?
For Elvis, yeah.
Okay.
I think we had some peanut butter cookies, and I don't think we had a problem.
People don't usually go to places like that if there's any possibility.
Okay.
A restaurant, if they're cooking peanuts in the kitchen, people can fall over and die.
Yes.
If they walk in the restaurant.
So,
I didn't bring my Elvis report with me, but I believe it's a certain cookie that's sold better than...
Probably snickerdoodles.
Why don't you let me know what that is? Because Mary is willing to make an assortment. So if we were doing 200, we could do 100 chocolate chip, 100, and then something, if there's something that did really well.
It says peanut butter cookies were the favorite and sold out first.
Oh, okay. People have great taste. I love peanut butter cookies.
They're not so sweet.
If you would like, we could do 200 peanut butter cookies, and then we could do chocolate chip and something else.
We don't want to put numbers down yet until we
get
our sales. I mean,
well, there's 400.
50-50.
There's seeds. There's 400 seeds.
But what if we don't sell that many tickets? There's no sense to make that.
That's true. But
I'm going to buy two cookies.
I was going to say, some people are going to buy more than one.
Yeah, I'm going to do one cookie. What if everybody buys two? Then we are short.
Well, if first one works,
we make 200 better.
So I don't know. So I believe that's all.
So we have snickerdoodles, chocolate chip, and peanut butter?
Or molasses, or she's got
molasses.
She's got, I was kind of going to leave that to her, but I can tell her peanut butter was the favorite.
We have 20 minutes, and we don't have a lot of time to sit through, four or five different kinds of cookies,
three cookies?
I mean, I'm making a decision.
That's fine.
But I'm not on the confession. I'll make sure to relay this to Jean, and if she has anything else to add, we'll email you.
Okay. But she and her staff will make the cookies and package the cookies.
That's awesome. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. So tickets should be, I think, limited to either sold here at the township or sold at the senior center. Because you're going to want, the people that handle our, that are authorized to handle our cash to be the ones that are taking the money. And I think, is that how we did all this? Buy tickets at the senior center and or the township?
We were a little more flexible because, for Elvis, we let people, like Joy, for instance, she sold 10 tickets. So she took 10 tickets, collected the money, and brought the money back to us.
Advisory board members were allowed to sell tickets. We, like, I had 10 tickets, and Joy had 10 tickets.
If you want to do that again, we can pursue that.
Yep.
But then also have, and then also,
also we
but then also the township.
Yeah, also the township and the senior center.
So we did, Cindy Picklow did sell tickets.
Yep, she did. Yeah, I think she did.
And so, does this mean that Jenna will be able to help us?
Yes, she'll sell tickets.
She will?
Yes, she will.
How about online sales?
We, no, we cannot do that. We do not have the capacity. We could take credit cards here in the township, but there's a fee associated with it. I don't remember what the percentage is, but it's like 3%.
So if we want to advertise that, we advertise, so that probably accepted at the township with a fee.
Yeah, with a fee.
I think all around it's cheaper.
Okay, but not online.
Jenna would not be able to do that. Jenna would be cash and check.
Right.
Yeah.
Online seems like a...
So, sorry, I know there's been other township events that they've said the same thing, but our treasurer has determined that that's not a feasible thing for us to do at this time.
Okay.
So. He's the boss.
There you go.
Is it considered a small additional fee or just say an additional fee?
We could just say for 3% of the total cost. I think we can.
I think there's a restaurant I go to that charges if you use your credit card, 3%.
On an amount, on a small amount, like a ticket, I think on $20, it's not going to be as, I mean, people pay it when they come in and pay their taxes. People will put it on a card and pay the fee. So that shocks me. I wouldn't want to spend my money like that, but.
Oh, I spend my money that way.
No.
Maybe more license plates and so on.
Yeah.
I'm not using my card.
No. Check. I mean, we tell people that. A lot of people go, they'll say, like, I'll be back with a check.
Yeah.
So
check, cash, or card at the township.
Yep.
What did you agree to about the board members selling tickets?
I think senior services advisory
board members, if that's what you would like to do, we can parse out whatever.
So what am I doing it, though? Am I going, and I'm saying that I want 10 tickets, and I bring the money to you, then you give
you would
it to me, and then I have to go get it.
No, you would have the tickets. Cost. You would collect cash or check at the time from the person. Like if you were selling
money. So you're going to give me 10 tickets?
Yes.
Okay.
And you're going to sell them to Sherry. If you sell one to Sherry, you're going to collect the $20.
Right. Give her her ticket. I'll put that down and I'll be accountable for 10 tickets.
And
but I don't have the cash out. And when I get the tickets, I give it to you when I collect the money.
Yes.
Okay.
That would be ideal.
Should we have it where we have to bring in the money first and buy the tickets?
No. I think that everyone here has been here and is you know trusted and accountable. So I think that you can take those.
But they do have to turn back in.
I know where to find you.
They're remembered also.
They are. So we're gonna say Kim has 1 through 10 and Nancy has 11 through 20 and
if number 16 comes up missing, you know who's responsible, you don't accept it at the door.
Yeah. Nancy.
Penny Rogers is coming to Charlotte.
Ooh.
And so many of the committee are going to see him. Dennis.
Oh.
Friday night.
Wonderful.
All right.
So the silent auction would be the same thing. Because it would happen, I'm guessing, at the event, it will need to be cash or check.
Is there enough time for silent auction?
Obviously, they did it with
fourth, yeah, I guess so.
We've asked for an extended intermission, so usually they might just do a 10-minute intermission, but we've asked for 20, so we can sell before and the show during intermission. And then we've asked for a longer set at the end, so we have time to cash out the auction.
Yes.
Okay.
And then, I did not know you had a list, but that's fantastic.
Kim made it.
Wonderful. I didn't realize that you made
We're on number four.
Four for the soliciting. So,
the list is just a list of Bath Township businesses. It's not necessarily the list of who wants to solicit.
Can I back up to number three?
Yes, please.
One of the things we did run into last year is there were some people that did not have enough cash with them or a checkbook or something like that. So what we did is Jenna would have them in the office. They would have to come to the senior center, pay her, and then they would get their item.
Okay. So, yep, either senior center or because the senior center isn't open, she could transfer it to the township when she's not here, the day she's not here.
Okay.
So, like, if they didn't come Monday, she would bring it to us so that if somebody showed up Tuesday, it would be here.
Yeah, that's true, because we know 5 days the week before. So.
Okay,
that's what we have to do now.
Yeah, so we'll coordinate that. Taylor and Jenna can coordinate that between, so that it's here if people come here.
Okay.
So Monday, Wednesday, Friday, they can go to the senior center. Tuesday, Thursday, they can come here.
Okay, and when we do advertise a silent auction, we do tell them cash or check there, but there's always some people that forget or something.
Yeah, I understand that. Or maybe they... So, my assessor, I was ill. She's gone this week. I will get Cindy a list that we can generate the best we can. We don't require them to tell us who is a home business, but when home businesses have personal property taxes, she would be able to generate that list of those people that we have forms, attorney forms for personal property. So I don't know what that list looks like. I've never had that list generated or seen that list during my time as superintendent. So I don't know what you're going to, I don't know what that's going to look like for you and Cindy. And Cindy did reach out to me. So
you're going to give that to her?
I'm going to.
You said your assessor.
The assessor will. Yeah, the assessor will generate the list from our tax database, her assessing database, and give that to Cindy. We'll email that to
her. The businesses that she can solicit to?
Yes. And I'm going to say that I will sign off if you could give me the list of.
The 150?
I saw her writing and thinking, so I was waiting for her. So solicitation requires approval from me.
Right.
I don't think you're competing with anything except possibly other events like that you do, where you solicit, for summer solstice and different things like that. I don't think at this time you're competing with any township programs that would be soliciting donations. So I don't have a problem with you approaching whoever's on your list.
So when is Easter? Because sometimes, she solicits for Easter baskets and the Easter egg hunt. That would be the only thing I would think that.
That's going to be March, when, April, late March. Early.
Yeah, when is Easter,
I wonder. But I can ask Becca that about Parks and Rec.
Right.
But so far, she really hasn't solicited anybody in her time here.
So what we're talking about is getting a hold of Wolverine Water Systems and was it Culligan for the water to donate? And you don't have a problem with us calling them and seeing if they're interested, or Meyer, or...
Meyer has, Al used to bring it to me frequently. They support community events, and you can actually fill out an application, and they might give you a gift card for $500, and you could go purchase whatever it was that you wanted to.
You don't have to apply for that much. You can apply for 200.
Yeah, you can.
Or 100.
And sometimes you can just say 5, and, if, and depending on where they're at in the year, they may only have a certain amount for you.
But sometimes I just ask, write a grant for 150 bottles of water.
There you go.
You know, just ask them for it.
So I do have that paperwork because we just filled out one with Chris Hagerman for the tree lighting ceremony that's going to take place. I have your email about the lights and I will respond to you. So you could do it for something specific or you could do it for
money
or
sizes. Can I go online and find out where the
information is? I've got it. I can email it to you.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. But I just don't think, in the past, there used to be a lot of crossover with, like, Becky in Parks and Recreation. She would solicit a lot. So we were constantly competing for the same resources, and I don't see that happening now as much as it used to. So I don't have a problem with you approaching, who you're approaching, and if you approach them all.
BSA was mentioned about putting up a poster at their office or something in their paychecks for the place to promote it. Mm-hmm. That's fine too.
I think so. I mean, if you contact the management of ESNA and they sign off on that, that's fine.
I thought if we couldn't use the senior center for the conversation, they have that great training building right by the library.
They really do.
Classrooms in there, we could use those. But never mind.
So I'm not going to limit who you approach.
Okay.
Great. In the
so
past,
you don't have to fill out a form.
No. I would, if you would just, so I'll have the list that obviously Beth provides for Cindy. Mm-hmm. If I just get a copy of your list, I will be fine with that.
Okay.
Question? And that
doesn't
even have to be now.
That's right.
Okay. If we solicit from outside of that, do we have to let me know?
No. You know, if,
just inside.
Just yeah. Because it really is about, if multiple groups, like the farmers market group or the parks and rec group, if you're all, I don't want to say begging, but if you're all asking the same businesses over and over and over,
right.
We sometimes used to get complaints where they would get to a point where they would support one thing, but then when, you know, Judy would go to ask for something, they wouldn't have anything left.
Yeah.
So sometimes it was just draining the resources mm-hmm. when you go to the well multiple times.
Yeah.
I don't, that's not happening now, though. So.
So you're saying we need to stay within the township for this?
No. But knowing who's being asked in the township is important.
I see.
Just so that if I get a call from Dollar Tree and they say, who's this Kim is calling me and asking me for something, I can say this is for this event and it's legitimate and, you know, go ahead and contact her back with your answer, so.
Do we have any special kind of badge or something that we can wear that would let them know we do represent the township?
You don't, but that's why if somebody were to call and check after you had contacted them, that's the most likely scenario, is you're going to ask for something from, let's say, MSU, Federal Credit Union. They contact me and say, you know, I was contacted by this dentist, and is this legit? And I would say, yes, we're promoting this, and you're actually trying to get items for the silent auction or for the event. You know, yes, it is. So.
Okay. And we will coordinate just this in our.
I mean, you can take a senior center, we have senior center cards. If that helps.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, if you feel intimidated.
We will, we'll coordinate inside our own group as far as.
Yep. Who's going to approach you?
Well, and where we're going to put our posters and stuff. We don't want two or three people going to Federal Credit Union and putting up posters, so.
But also if you're asking for things, too, from the silent auction, right. Which, you know, Cindy will do, and if she's the only one doing that, then you're not going to be competing with that, so.
Yeah, she's taking that on.
She did a fantastic job last
time. Oh my
She's
God.
Done
she
it a
did.
Couple of times.
She did a lot.
She's phenomenal.
Yep. I agree.
Okay.
Township van. So that is the same day as Tom King Joe Day. I'm going to say that you're going to be hard-pressed to get a volunteer because people
almost all of our staff works that day for 6 hours, and people are usually
tired.
It's hard work. So I was thinking, and I don't know what you think about this, contacting Melissa
at
Clinton Transit, or contacting where your dad was, mm-hmm. because they had a bus at one time too. Mm-hmm. I'm wondering if they would support us.
Oh, we can find out. But is it possible that Cheryl could drive again?
If she were willing to take that on, yeah.
Because she's associated with the township. Mm-hmm. I mean, just, yep. I'm just going to ask.
Yeah. Look at you.
So
she could go drive a horse trailer.
Right.
She could blow him up.
So
that's impressive.
Can we use the van? Do we have to rent?
Yes.
Do we have to reserve it?
We will reserve it. We'll make sure it's clean and gassed. And
so if Sherry is available, you check your schedule. If not, I'll find, we'll try to find someone else, some other transportation.
Is there some way that one of us could, take a special driving class or something to get approved?
It's really about the liability.
Just, we've got to make sure we're insured. I've driven a huge
risk. So, it really is having an employee or other people, because we check driving records. I mean, right away you did it with you before, but it gets a little dicey with volunteers.
That's what I was wondering.
Yeah, it's really a liability.
It's checking with the insurance company so that we know we're insured. So, driving van.
But because she's a board member or an employee, and I would offer an employee, and I would even pay them overtime if that were the case, but I really believe that our employees are going to be it's all hands on deck for Tom King.
Yeah, for Tom King.
So, unfortunately, it's the same day, so that's the only issue. I mean, and there still might be somebody like Linda willing to do that, because she's a machine.
If Sherry can drive it,
but if Sherry's willing,
and it's available, then that kind of solves that problem.
It does.
And if we sell 400 tickets, if we don't sell 400 tickets,
it might not be an issue.
Right. 200 tickets, then won't be an issue, but just in case. Right. So the contract for the entertainer.
Yes, it's done. He actually emailed it. I copied both of you on the email.
Today.
Okay.
My email's not set up yet.
Your township email?
Yeah. There's something going on.
Well, we will help you with that.
Okay. We'll even come over.
We will help you with that. Taylor will help you.
She said Taylor said she would help.
Yeah. Don't be silly. Al and Joe have been here several times, even during their time when they forget their password. Or they say, I can't get in. Yeah. Reset my password.
Why
Sherry, we will help you.
Okay.
Okay, so the contract is done. I can actually even give it to you if you want it. It's in the email, but it's scanned into the email.
Okay, thank you very much.
So, talk to me about your bests.
Well, when Dennis and I were talking, and I'm trying to think it through, the things that we might need, like ice for the coolers for the water, or if... you know, we have these different parking lots that we have to have volunteers wear vests.
So we have vests that are DPW approved.
Okay.
We could loan those.
How many do you have available?
Like 5. We have 5 people that ordinarily would wear that type
Judy
of safety.
Has 3, I believe.
Yeah, oh. I have some at home. Because of the summer solstice.
Oh, okay, really? You just have those laying around?
Well, for the summer solstice party. It's very important. I think that's
true.
Over the streets.
So, and DPW for bus, glow lights.
It's going to be dark.
Flashlights?
Yes. What I had for a resource for someone that just had the same situation in Chatsford where they had it. At different parking lots, and they had to park for our church.
Okay.
So there was over 600 guests, mm-hmm. and they said that when they used flashlights, they weren't very effective because it's just one light, and when they pointed somebody, you're pointing it in their face. But they really liked the glow sticks because you could tell them to go with this way.
Okay.
And it was a better way to
show direction. Let me see if we have
$4 at Meijer.
Oh, if we need to buy them, we can buy them. But let me check with DPW because I don't.
Okay.
But sometimes our public safety has to do things like that.
If we get a grant from Myers, we could buy that with the grant if we don't have them available yet.
Yep.
So glow.
I was thinking those little glow sticks, but now I understand what you're saying.
Now, also, her question is, if we do run into situations where there's something we want to buy,
so there is...
Okay, if we approve it as a committee, do we go ahead and buy it and then turn in a slip for reimbursement? Or is it better for us to request money from you and then have you write a check?
So, I honestly think that it would probably be the easiest... it may be that you would purchase it and we would reimburse you. Because you're not authorized to use the township credit card. I was just trying to think through that. But also, to Judy's point, if we got the Meijer gift cards, we could also use those to purchase those things too. I'm just trying to think through this.
Right.
We may even have gift cards. I know you tried to take one once for summer solstice and it was not
activated.
Activated.
I brought it back. No, they kept it at Myers and said I couldn't keep it. No.
Let me ask Jennifer if we have.
Karen was being so generous.
I was trying.
The township was going to help support the summer solstice, and oh, here's a gift card, you know. And it wouldn't work.
Surprise.
It was hilarious.
Do we offer napkins too with the cookies?
I don't think we do.
Absolutely do.
Well, if it's in a baggie, you can just eat over the baggie.
I don't know, but how you demand that today.
Do we have to clean up afterwards? We're paying a custodian.
No, the custodian gets paid by the school to help us, but you suggested getting them up to do
it. Always in the past, they don't have to turn up.
That's me.
Okay. Okay. I get what you're saying. That makes sense.
It's always done.
Check on this. If it was verified. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Let me see if these are working.
A year ago.
If they're working, I have 200 and then I have one for 140-103.
So this is what you're saying, Karen, is that you could give us that
yes,
card.
Yes, and that you could
you could use this money towards the event. We just have to keep the receipt.
You would just bring me back, just like this, you would just bring back the receipt.
Yeah.
So we're going to verify these, and then we can give these to you guys. Okay?
Thank you very much.
And then you can just purchase.
Okay.
So I'll verify these.
Don't we make ice, Karen?
We just got a fantastic new ice machine.
Okay.
Right, and so the senior center has these nice big coolers. We used to use them for bath days.
Yes.
So we can use those coolers, I assume, and fill them with ice from the township. And
they're coolers? How many?
Huge coolers.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, they're 55 gallons.
Oh, they're
big. We would probably make the ice and then have maybe DPW take it down.
Yeah, fill the coolers and then take them down, right? That shouldn't be a problem.
Awesome.
Yeah. I jumped around a little bit on you.
So we're on eight.
So it'll be the same thing. I kept that poster so we could use the graphics from that. and then work with Kim to approve a flyer that could be used in print. And then we could help modify, just like the thing with Doak, we would modify that for the paper. I don't think the township has a Twitter, but Bath Township website, Facebook.
It shows Twitter on my homepage on the bottom.
Really?
Yeah, I saw it. It's a little bluebird on there.
I don't Twitter, so.
I don't either.
I don't tweet.
If I don't have any followers, no one's going to see it by advertising Twitter.
Yeah, well, let me, that's our website.
Yeah.
Taylor's so good. We probably do have a Twitter, but I don't even.
I wonder what.
I hate to say, I don't even know that we do.
What does she tweet about?
I don't. Probably.
Right. Who knows?
Who knows? Bath Township. I'm glad you said that to me. Because I didn't know that, Kim.
Oh, you
just taught me something about my own township.
It's a good name for everybody now.
Okay, so we'll just work together on that messaging and on the plan of when you want to start advertising the tickets. And I'm assuming you're going to do tickets at the door. Did we do that for Elvis,
we
too?
We did. Yeah, okay. We raised the rate.
Once you can still look, you too. We're even on Pinterest.
Yeah, I didn't think Pinterest would be something we could use, though. I don't know.
What's happening?
I don't know what we're tweeting right up
ahead. I am.
We're tweeting about what? What are we tweeting?
Oh, no.
I know, but you know what I'm saying about the concert? It's like people aren't going to go on Pinterest to look at the concert.
So, Karen, if we have questions while you're gone, aren't you going on vacation?
I am. I'm going to Hawaii.
Yeah, for 2 weeks or something.
No, from the 8th. Yeah, I wish. But 8th and 8th to the 16th. Yes.
When?
Grandma is a 91-year-old grandma, me, my partner, and our 20-year-old son.
Do you
He does, but we don't.
Right. And you're leaving December 16th, did you say?
The 8th.
December 8th.
Through the 16th.
Through the 16th. So if we have questions in your absence, what should we do?
You should talk to Taylor. And I'm going to brief her on all of this. I can't get into Twitter right now. I'll just ignore that. So that she is up on all of this.
Okay.
Check for the entertainers. We will cut a check here at the township. We will run accounts payable, whatever it is before that event. We will cut the check and we will provide that to you so that you can pay them on that night.
So what am I doing? You're checking with you 2 weeks before the event and they just said remind me.
Yep, we had them put in a check request. And we do that commonly with Parks and Recreation and with different things where we pay people on site. So we'll make sure that that's cut before then, so that you can hand it to.
So last time, Joy and I made these yard signs. Do you remember the yard signs that Joy and I made, Dennis?
I do remember.
We made about 20 of them, right?
I asked Joy if she still had the ones from then, and she said no. And what she did is she borrowed from Cindy Crump. She borrowed the metal signs.
Metal
things, yeah.
I wonder if we could get some.
Oh, we can get those. I mean, they're all around. But I'm wondering, should we plan to make handmade some yard signs about the event, or do we have
resources? I always talked to Joy, and she said she's willing to do that again.
Oh,
all
right. I'll
make those.
All right, yard signs. I'll help her. I'll help her.
How can they be made by hand? Because we're putting together posters, can't we?
To save money.
Why did we do it?
Why handmade?
We did them handmade.
Not professionally printed. Mm-hmm.
Right. Joy wanted to do it herself. She was an elementary school teacher. She likes her penmanship. She considered it an art project, so we just sit down and
bake. And she donated all the supplies out of her own pocket.
How do you keep it dry? If you're not putting it on,
use the
poster.
Waterproof markers.
Okay.
Magnet markers.
All right.
Just need to identify the locations, and then that determines how many yard signs you want. And when you want them to go up. ASAP printing. This is about the program.
That's
a lot of questions about the program.
Okay, so that is who we have been using. We don't have to. Kim, if you're familiar, or another printer, but we would
Okay.
That is who we use.
All right.
They're great.
I think they are.
I use them for a lot of stuff.
Well, she said she has some that she might be able to get us cheaper through.
Who? Joy.
Said she has, I think it was a relative or something.
Oh.
Who's got a printing place.
Well.
So I asked her to get us some prices.
I mean, as long as it's a reputable business, I don't have a problem working with.
And one of the reasons you're going to the show is to look at the program, isn't it, Kim?
Yes.
Yes.
Because there are a lot of questions about the program.
Did you have a program?
Did we find a program from last year?
I haven't found it. Didn't they keep one in the file here for some reason?
I haven't seen it.
She probably hasn't looked.
With my business.
No, I actually, I did.
Did you look?
I did.
Did you look?
I don't think Dan, it was just Dan, I don't think he kept one.
Yeah, it's so strange because they put a lot of effort into that. I wonder if Cindy had the copy. Cindy, well, she's kind of a saver. I'll reach out to her and ask her.
I have not found anyone that saved one. I don't know if I've ever got one.
But if you nab one from Cindy, when you go to Charlotte, we could certainly replicate something.
Well, I have a few different sample verbiages of different sites I came up with that he's working from. Okay. Our problem is that it's Dolly, too. And Dolly needs to be on the picture. If you're putting him on the picture in the front, and we don't have a picture of the children together.
Oh.
We have him with
another impersonator.
Yeah, we have
Because
it's another impersonator. It's not the one.
It's not that one.
And the other impersonator, the Dolly, I couldn't find any verbiage on her. I have to scrape her it off.
Okay.
So
no picture?
No.
Darn.
And he has a
not from Johnny Rapp. Is it Johnny Rapp?
Yeah.
He doesn't have anything?
He doesn't have anything on there. So I think he. I think you're doing.
Can we reach out to her?
Yeah, I could do that.
I'm not trying to work.
No, I don't have a contact for her. She's from Canada.
Oh.
She's supposed to be handling everything for them.
Okay.
And then when it gets up to real close to the event, then I have a cell phone to contact Kenny directly.
Now that he has a signed contract, he might be more willing to help us. You know, get a picture of her. Send us a picture of the two of them together.
Because they want this to be successful.
Right. Give us a bio on her.
No, please, no.
Now with a contract, maybe he'll be more likely to help us out.
One of the reasons I wanted a copy of the other program was to see, I know we had several advertisers in there.
Yeah.
And I thought, oh, maybe we can hit up some of the same advertisers.
So, I remember doing the ticket, because I designed the ticket.
I do remember that.
But
I like that ticket. Do you like that? Don't you think it looks pretty good right there? It looks simple.
Now I'm going.
Colorful, you know, and we don't have to include as much information as they did on it. But I thought that was pretty good. You know,
the only thing that we didn't do last time is assign a seat.
We can't.
Yeah, we did like a first come, first serve.
Yeah, we have to. We don't have a CTM program
to generate.
Yeah. And the seats
so last time, I remember we couldn't.
No, in fact, Joy hand numbered them. Mm-hmm. They didn't even number them. Joy had them hand number all the tickets, all 400.
That's funny because when I sent them to the printer, I would have thought I would have been able to say, like, I want to number them.
She had to do it by hand.
Well, this year we can remedy that.
That would be wonderful.
We'll
Nancy, well, they also have a seat on them.
That's what I'm saying. We couldn't do that because they're not labeled at the auditorium.
I thought they were.
They are labeled, but it's like if I take 10 seats and then I sell, you know, 9. What am I doing with that last number? It just gets thrown away because it's not now. It's not with. Dennis's that started at where mine dropped off. You know what I'm saying?
The seats are.
Well, we could change the method instead of letting everybody take 10 tickets. We just say they have to go through here or.
The only way around it is to have a grid in front of you that shows all the seats and if they, you know, actually X out those 4 seats that are 2 in off the aisle. Mm-hmm. And it would have to be, everybody has to come to that person that has the grid. Otherwise, you can't sell them tickets.
So
you don't want. And like when you go to Wharton Center, they won't allow you to leave an empty space in between. Mm-hmm. And so you have to talk to the person when they come and say, well, you might want a center, but you got to have it right here because...
How did that work when we did the first come, first serve?
The problem we had with first come, first serve is we had people showing up way before we even had the options set up. It really caused us problems. In winter, you don't want to keep the doors locked and say, I'm sorry, you got to wait out there. So that was our biggest problem with. Also, the entertainers didn't want them coming in too early.
I was going to say, if there was a preference, you would say entry at, if the show's at 6, doors open at, and then you just really don't.
And then, we did that last year. We did say doors open at this amount of time, but we had people...
Nope.
Don't look at me like I...
People want to show up early to get my seats.
Well, I understand that, I think you have to doors open at, and you have to keep it locked until...
Well, Dan said they had ushers or volunteers keeping people away from the doors of the
auditorium. They kept them from going into the auditorium. But the problem we had was that they were piling around the doors, and we had trouble setting up the auction because of that.
We haven't really decided the auction. I have not been able to get a hold of the school. They haven't called me back. I'm going to go with a suggestion that someone had to contact the school superintendent or something and say, I haven't heard back from these two employees, and I called them each or emailed them 6 times, and they're still not responding because we really need to figure out where we're going to set up the concessions and the silent auction.
Who are you dealing with?
The John Peckett, the director of facilities, and RJ Parks, who's the network specialist.
Okay.
Is the guy we talked to that day we were there one of those guys?
No,
because that guy said we can give you as many tables as you need.
He said he wasn't interested in helping us out with volunteering to help us with the sound system, that guy that was there when we did the tour.
Oh, right, yeah. I didn't figure he would be able to. But he's the one that said he can get us.
He said we have
2 tables here, but we can get you more tables if you need them, which we do.
But there's the concern is the congestion, and I don't know if we're going to end, how we're going to manage that.
Well, right. That's what I was saying here. We have to keep the doors locked and not let people to show up too early. Yeah.
And we're going to show up.
You're going to have to say doors open at such and such a time, but the lobby where the cider auction is will be over here.
Oh, yeah. We're going to be there early. But we can't let any patrons come in until we say at 7, we say doors are open at 6:30. We can't let anyone in before 6:30. They're going to have to congregate outside the door.
Or shop at the silent auction. Or buy something from the concession. Or just sit around.
Yeah, I don't think it's a bad idea to have people in the building early if they're buying concessions and they're
Concessions. They weren't shopping the auction. They were filing at the door because they wanted to get in there first. Since they were assigned seats, they wanted to get
the
seat.
Put the code on your seat and then maybe come out and get the
That's
what I do too. Yeah. So I just talked to Becca. She's our Parks and Recreation coordinator. Mm-hmm. And she said that she's also had difficulty. She's emailed and she's actually went there 3 times. And she keeps getting pushed off too, like you
they
are.
They want you in that meeting. And I security
said that maybe what needs to happen is I need to contact Paul Hertzig and let him know that his people are not being responsive.
Yeah, I was going to suggest that. I did suggest that I would go with Kim, but perhaps if you called him, that would be very helpful.
Because she said she was trying to deal with John Planchette. Is that correct?
Peckett.
Okay, thank you. And that she's not getting anywhere either.
Yeah, he just said when we were down there initially, months ago for a tour, because we had to tell the entertainers if there was dressing rooms available.
Yeah, remember you going to do a site visit. Yeah.
And we took pictures of sound system and such. He just said they're all swamped. They just all just had way too much to do with the school system. Plus, our situation was we needed somebody to run the sound system, and the guy that was there that knows all about it said he wasn't willing. And then because the band director also knows the sound system in the curtains too, but he said he's a teacher, he's a band director, he's all spread out, he's not available.
Well, the thing is that we rely, the township and the school rely on each other for a lot of things, and so we can't afford to just push each other off. Mm-hmm. So I don't like hearing, especially from Becca, because I haven't talked to her about it, and you not being able to get what you need,
mm-hmm.
because they contact us and want things, and you know, we try to accommodate. So there's a give and take, is all I'm saying. Mm-hmm. And I'm just trying to help, but I didn't realize she was also having trouble.
It's
so
a partnership,
so
sure.
we need to really probably get a hold of Paul and let him know that things are being accommodated.
I don't want to, if you
just let me know then, because I don't want to, I'll be assertive. I'll just say, oh, your people aren't responding.
So are you going to try to see him, did you say? Paul?
No, I'm not going to try to see him, but I might email him.
Yeah, I would email him.
I just say I was trying to get a hold of these two employees for the last mm-hmm. 2 months, and voicemail or email, I'm not getting responses. Here's our situation.
Like I said, she gets pushed to his email, and she's like, oh.
And maybe they'll give you someone else to see instead, possibly.
Is there someone
it's just frustrating. I mean, I know it's school and they're busy, but...
Yeah, but there should be someone in the admin office who can help us answer questions about
that. Were we in the middle school? Is that where Janine is? Janine Brown?
Mm-hmm. Oh, she's in the elementary school.
Oh, I got the wrong... Okay. Mm-hmm. I was going to say, because we have a good relationship with her. She's on board with you.
And she just does media stuff.
Maybe she could help us, but...
Yeah, but she's in the elementary school.
Okay.
Yeah, I just said, all I need is a janitor to let me in. She said, no, for security reasons, we can't do that. It's got to be John Paget. And I'm like, all right, so I'm just kind of counseling. Mm-hmm. I have no other questions. I just need counseling. So.
Okay.
Anyway, thank you.
Well, so if I can help you.
You got everything except one thing I had put on the list was cash boxes. You guys have the cash boxes for us.
We
have two different concessions.
And we could have them ready with change, so that you can, you know, like I'll talk to Jennifer and Steve about if you're doing cookies for 50 cents and if you're doing the silent auction, what the protocols
would be. Yeah, do we keep the silent auction money separate? Is it going to be in an envelope or a cash box?
Probably, only because I'm thinking that you'll want to be able to record it and look back and say, okay, I'm going to make $1,000 on silent auction and we sold all the cookies and we made $200 or whatever.
We did keep the money separate for the silent auction.
Okay.
So that's your reason, so in my report I could say,
the tickets. So then you'll know what we made up each thing. Ticket sales, cookies, and silent auction.
Right.
Yeah.
And it's fine with the township that we ask the seniors if they have something that they want to contribute. If they're crocheting potholders or whatever, that's fine.
Oh, yeah. I think that's great. And I do think we have some artisans and makers that probably would do that.
Okay. Here's a question that also didn't make it on our sheet.
Okay.
Where do we store the silent auction stuff?
If you would like to store it here, we do have room. I don't know how much stuff you're talking about.
Well, Cindy said a lot of it is coupons and like that, so they first will take up a lot of room.
So we would make a record of that, and we could store that in our. So we have a vault and we have a safe. So the vault room is a room in the back, and it contains the vault. It doesn't have to go in the safe, but it could be in the vault room.
Okay.
Now, if you had items,
well, for example, let me give you an example of that basketball, signed basketball.
Yeah, that's still in there.
Was supposed to be in that auction. We couldn't get into it. It was kept in either your office or Dan's office. I don't remember which.
Okay.
And we couldn't get to it that night.
It's in the vault.
Together.
It's still here.
So we put it in this year.
Put it in this year.
But I've already got people donating things like quilts and stuff like that. So.
Okay. So
we need some place that we can store it. Some of the items might be big things. So I guess that's what I'm wondering. Where I asked Cindy if, I think she stored some of the stuff at her place last year. She said she can't do it this year.
Okay.
So I didn't know.
I'm going to think about that.
Okay.
Because I Unfortunately, I'm even stressed to the point of, like, we had a hard time making sure that our election equipment was separate from everything else and stored in another key, and so we don't have a lot of spaces. We have the basement. So I guess if we made a record of, this is the list of the inventory of the items, and we have maybe a crate or a big box down there, people aren't going to mess with it. I mean, it's like our DPW people or the police officers going down there to work out. So it's not like it's accessible to the public, but we would just, so that we were all on the same page, maybe have an inventory of those items and be able to put them in that particular place. It's up to you.
I did buy, because I wasn't sure if I might have room to store them at my place.
Okay.
But I went, about a month ago, I bought a bunch of those plastic tubs.
Oh, okay.
But I bought the ones that don't have any holes in
right.
them, so you
okay.
can environment them.
Right. Yeah, yeah. And we don't have issues with broken downstairs.
Okay.
So it would be secure. We have a dehumidifier down there, so it's not damp. So,
that's good.
I mean, most of the stuff that's in the basement is paperwork and files and things we're required to keep by law. So, yeah. And then
right, so there's room for us.
Yes.
If we can. Okay.
I'm just letting you know, like, okay. it's going to be, yes, it could be in the basement.
Okay.
Not accessible to the public or anybody else, just
okay.
like township employees.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Would we be able to?
No, you'd have to go through, you'd have to give it, you'd have to, yeah, we'd have to, or have DPW be down at the basement doors and they let you in, put it in. Yeah.
So, Karen, in your absence, you will not be here for our next Senior Services Advisory Committee.
Okay.
So, in your absence, during that 10 days, should we just hold our questions or go to Taylor?
Well, you can go to Taylor.
Mm-hmm.
She'll do, I'm sure she'll do her best. She tries to make decisions like I would, so.
Right. I'm just wondering, you know, if we should just wait or if we should go to
It's up to you.
However
you want to, if you want to wait. Be happy to have this when you got back, or if it's something that can't wait.
Right.
And I will get in contact with her,
so sure.
I'll be able to
yeah.
ask her calls.
Kim, do you have any other questions?
No, I have to say that everything went really well. Thank you.
You're welcome. This was amazing. I loved having, when I saw your first email, I was like, oh, and I was like, yes. And then I got your second one, and I was like, this is great.
Well, we tried to be organized.
I loved it.
You got to make sure you post some pictures.
I just want you guys to know that I've been asked to do the accounting for how many meetings we've attended, we've had, and we've attended. And the only meetings that count are the ones where we have a quorum once a month when we sit here. And I asked, because many people had asked for excused absences, if they were given an excused absence, were they counted for the meeting? And no. So the only meetings that are counted are meetings that are here in this building in front of that camera that you're present for.
Correct. It's the same for everybody.
And are they considered a meeting because you
it was noticed and
noticed
we're here and we have a quorum. So yes.
So today counts.
Yes.
Okay. Any other questions? Thank you so much for being with us today, Sherry.
Yeah,
all the things you're holding, Sherry.
This is a big
list. The last page is an email, so you don't need a copy of the email, but
okay.
The Senior Services Advisory Board meeting is December 13th at 3 o'clock here.
Okay.